Hi everybody. I wanted to do a quick video. I've been kind of on a mission for products. Skincare has gotten to be so high-tech and so complicated, and there are so many new ingredients, and a lot of them are quite fragile ingredients. And so the more that I investigate, the more concerned I am about the kind of packaging that products come in. And prior to this point in time, I had used SkinMedica, and I don't remember, SkinMedica something complex, C complex. I have used cosmetic skin solutions. I have used the Skinceuticals CE Ferulic. What really drove it home for me was not only a ton of research that I did, but getting into this and finding this. This, to me, is no longer a pale yellow. There's also some kind of precipitate in this, and so I'm of the opinion at this point in time that this is no longer any good, that this has oxidized, and that this is not only not beneficial for my skin, but potentially harmful for my skin. So for $130 and two-thirds of this bottle left, this is not good anymore. Quite expensive for a third of an ounce of product. And never was in love with this bottle. When I had a cosmetic skin solutions one that came in a bottle just like this, I knocked it over once, it spilled. I'm just not a fan of this, not a fan of this packaging, and ceasing to be a fan of products that come in jars at all. Exposing every time you open, exposing everything in there to the air. So, I have been on a mission to find my vitamin C. I found my vitamin C. This is BeautyRx Skincare. It is by Dr. Schultz. It comes in a box like this. The first amazing thing about this is that it is all simplified. Right on the top, there are instructions to use. All of these products have a number. Use the products from the lowest to the highest number, which is really, really helpful. There have been skincare lines in the past that I have been totally lost in as to what order they should be applied. This takes all the guesswork out of that. This is perfect packaging, in my humble opinion. This is perfect. This protects from light. Obviously, you don't want to set it next to your heater. It could get hot, that could damage the contents, but the biggest issue is the lack of exposure to oxygen, the lack of exposure to air, because you're not taking off anything. You're just pumping it out. And so I think the bottle is just absolutely perfect because you don't have that product degradation. There does indicate that there is some fragrance in here. It's very light. I don't really get any scent. It's very much a pale yellow gel, and I really love the consistency of it too. It's quite thick. The Skinceuticals, the cosmetic skin solutions, runs all over everywhere. I mean, okay, we'll put bad. It's running down my hand, that little drop. The BeautyRx is still sitting here. And pardon me, I want to wipe the Skinceuticals off my hand. It is rapidly absorbing, leaves my skin feeling so nice, absolutely so nice, and no tackiness. There is my favorite, my new favorite, Tetrahexyldecyl Ascorbate in this product. And there is also another stabilized vitamin C derivative, and that is methylselenol ascorbate. There is Japanese green tea leaf extract that is for antioxidant protection and anti-inflammatory compounds. There is vitamin E acetate. There is a proprietary blend of antioxidants, and I think this is amazing for the price. There, I think it's amazing. This is 1 ounce for $85. This was $130, and considering I only got to use a third of it before it went to crap. Pardon me. Before it got bad. This became even pricier, and this is really pretty much in line with anything else I looked at. Jan Marini, Dr. Dennis Gross, trying to think who else I've looked at so many manufacturers of vitamin C. And this has an alcohol-based delivery system, not a silicone-based one, which is what a lot of them have, and no L-ascorbic acid. So my expectation is for this to remain to be a stable product, a good product, until I get to the end of it, until I use all of it. And very comparable in price, and absolutely worth it to get a good product. So that is my review of the vitamin C serum. The only thing that I am not sure about, and this would be something that we could ask Dr. Schultz, there is a lot code on the bottom of this box, and I am presuming that if someone wanted to know, that that would be something that someone on his website, that would be information that they would be willing to provide if you wanted to know the date. That this was manufactured. Again, since it doesn't have the L-ascorbic acid, I don't think it's as big a deal. I did not, in case someone will ask, I did not use my own pH test strips on this. If someone would like me to do that, I will certainly do it. I would be willing to bet that it's between 3 and 3.5. But I will certainly test it if someone would like me to test it. So if you have any questions, let me know. I appreciate you watching. Look forward to reading your comments, and I will see everybody soon. Bye.